Hello, my name is Gail Faria Craig, and I will be coming overseas to Lisbon, Portugal, to speak to you in June of this year. I am through the moon excited to be coming to visit you. When I land in June on the Iberian Peninsula, I will have visited that area of the country three times in the past 4 years. The first two times, I visited Madrid, Spain, and I had the wonderful pleasure of getting to know many Portuguese and Spanish veterinarians and spending time with them, breaking bread, talking over coffee breaks, lunches, dinners, late night discotheques, and just discussing the things that matter to us most in our practices and how to take our veterinary practice management of these practices to the next level. The main concern that veterinarians have expressed to me in your area of the world over the past few years is that you're trying to be three things at once. You're trying to be the practice owner, the practice manager, and a full-time practicing veterinarian. And something suffers. What suffers is your home life and your life outside of the practice. At a time when many veterinarians have owned their practices for a decade or more and have felt that at this time in their life, why isn't everything running smoothly? Why can't I spend time outside of my practice and not worry about it? Why do I feel like I have to be standing there at all times to make sure that the customer service is exactly the way I want it delivered and that everybody is behaving and acting and treating the pets and the clients the way that I would when I'm there? Most of the veterinarians feel overworked, underappreciated by their employees, and that their employees don't take pride in their work. And because of these factors, many practice owners have told me that customer service is not only suffering, but they're losing their passion for what they went to school for, their passion for caring for animals and for running the business and providing a place, a safe haven, to take care of pets. They're just exhausted and overwhelmed. Some have even told me that they're considering selling their practices and getting out of the field. Well, before you decide to take that leap, please come visit me in June in Lisbon, Portugal. I would love to talk to you, get to know you, speak to you about the ideas that have come to me over the past few years of how to fix those problems in your practice. I'll help you recognize your own strengths and those of your employees, identify where your strengths and those of your employees are best utilized in your practice from day to day, and maximize those strengths in yourself and others, inspiring everyone to rise to their full potential and want to work for you, taking pride in their work. We'll talk about how to fix how you communicate with your employees rather than retreat to your office. We will talk about relating. And we will talk about building and strengthening those relationships inside the four walls of your hospital. We'll shift your mindset on delegation, trust, and authority, and we'll break the stereotypes of job titles and roles in your practice. And I'll also help you appreciate the individuals in your practice in the language that they speak best, not just Portuguese, but in their appreciation language, how they like to be treated, and how that helps them want to be a better employee for you and helps them continue to provide excellent service through the years, not just a Band-Aid. So please, please, I urge you, come visit me in Lisbon in June. I really do want to meet you and I want to learn from you as well. I'm not just there to teach, and that's the truth. Ultimately, once we get together, my goal is that when you leave there, you will feel like you have the tools to go back to your practice and become a happy hospital owner that enjoys a successful work-life balance. I look forward to meeting you. Ciao.